Staffers and reporters at CNN are accusing the cable news network of regurgitating Israeli propaganda while simultaneously censoring the Palestinian perspective as they cover the ongoing war on Gaza. Now, according to accounts from 6 CNN staffers in multiple newsrooms and more than a dozen internal memos and emails obtained by The Guardian, daily news decisions apparently are shaped by a flow of directives from the CNN headquarters in Atlanta that have set strict, incredibly strict guidelines on their coverage. Now, they include tight restrictions on quoting Hamas and reporting other Palestinian perspectives, while at the same time just printing statements from the Israeli government, and they're also taken at face value. So don't publish or talk about what, you know, Palestinians are saying, what Hamas is saying. You should be super skeptical of anything they have to say. But when it comes to the Israeli government, you print it, you don't question it, you take what they're saying at face value. In addition, The Guardian reports, every story on the conflict must be cleared by the Jerusalem Bureau before broadcast or publication. So this was actually something that was initially reported by The Intercept. And so the Jerusalem Bureau chief, his name is Richard Green, told staff in a memo in the very beginning of this war that they're going to do something known as second eyes. That's the program that they're going to implement in order to ensure that they're doing accurate reporting. They consider it a safety net, so we don't use imprecise language or words that may sound impartial but can be coded, can have coded meanings. And then so one result of second eyes is that Israeli official statements, again, are quickly cleared and they make it on air on the principle that they are to be trusted at face value. Statements and claims from Palestinians, though, not just Hamas, Palestinian civilians, Palestinian officials, are delayed or never reported at all. One CNN staffer said edits by second eyes often seemed aimed at avoiding criticism from pro-Israel groups. They gave the example of Green's, remember that's the bureau chief in Jerusalem, Richard Green, of Green's intervention to change a headline. Israel is nowhere near destroying Hamas, a perspective widely reflected in the foreign and Israeli press. It was replaced with a headline that shifted the focus from whether Israel could achieve its stated justification for killing thousands of Palestinian civilians. Quote, 3 months on, Israel is entering a new phase of the war. Is it still trying to destroy Hamas? And I remember that framing, the framing of like, oh, Israel, the IDF is now moving on to the next stage of their war, without any real analysis in regard to whether their goal of destroying Hamas is being achieved in any way. One CNN staffer said that the majority of news since the war began, regardless of how accurate the initial reporting, has been skewed by a systemic and institutional bias within the network toward Israel. Ultimately, CNN's coverage of the Israel-Gaza war amounts to journalistic malpractice. That is not a third party that's saying this. That is a literal CNN staffer who The Guardian spoke to saying this. And it's not just the staffers. Journalists in CNN newsrooms in the United States and overseas say that broadcasts have in fact been skewed by management and their edicts and a story approval process that has resulted in a highly partial coverage. And look, I want to just quickly note, there have been some gems. In all of this, there have been some incredible reports. Jeremy Dimon, who reported on the graves that have been destroyed in Gaza. Excellent reporting there. And whenever they do the excellent reporting, we do give them credit because they deserve the credit. But if you look at their reporting as a whole, it is, in fact, more favorable to Israel's side as opposed to what's happening to Palestinians in Gaza. And another journalist spoke to The Guardian and said, basically described a schism within the network over coverage they said was at times reminiscent of the cheerleading that followed 9/11. Quote, there's a lot of internal strife and dissent. Some people are looking to get out, end quote. Other journalists agree. I have more statements from them. But Cenk, I have no doubt you're chomping at the bit. So jump in.
Yeah. So first, again, we're fair. Clarissa Ward has done some great reporting for CNN out of Gaza. Jeremy Diamond's done some great reporting disproving what the IDF was claiming. from inside Gaza. And Jay Tapper is mentioned in the piece as being very friendly to Israel, and he has been throughout his career, and he has been about half the time in this case too, leaning towards their version of the story unquestioningly. But at different times, he's been pretty good at pressing Israeli officials. So credit where credit is due, and I'll take any kind of movement. And so this version of CNN is actually better than previous versions of CNN, where it was 100% Israeli propaganda. But what is really interesting about this story is the confirmation of all the things we've told you through all of these years. And here is reporters at CNN from the inside saying, yes, we are told that you must report the Israeli statements as facts, when they all know it's propaganda. And this whole, they also do the same thing with the US Pentagon. Look at how the American press, pretending to be objective, in reality, very actively, consciously, with memos, directs their reporters and their anchors to be biased in favor of Western powers, US and Israel. And they say, if we say it, print it. If the other side says it, don't. Where they have to jump through 28 different hurdles. And then if they make it through those hurdles, at the end, we'll still say, well, it was their fault. And Israel, it was only retaliating, and they were trying to protect innocent civilians, but Hamas, the dirty terrorists, made them do it. It's, I mean, like, it is so brazen and is so clear now. So when you're watching these mainstream media networks, buyer beware, they are not telling you the news. They're telling you some form of marketing that the powerful wants you to think. And so, and finally, in terms of what's great about this story, from my perspective, is it tells you why. Though it's a huge story, and I'm reading. Okay, yes, but what's driving it, right? Because I know, like, the anti-Semitic tropes aren't true, right? It's not like there's a cabal of Jews that tell them to do this. It's that's not true. But what happens is it's advertisers. If you don't do pro-Israel coverage, advertisers pull out. Okay, and that is super interesting. What I would love to see is which advertisers pulled out, why they pulled out, were their defense contractors, oil companies, etc. What? Why are advertisers demanding twisted, biased coverage in favor of Israel and against Palestinians? And that's a great question.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.